Then my father grew up. He joined the Foreign Service in 1912 and was therefore in the Foreign Service when war came in 1914. And the Foreign Service was known as a reserved profession. You didn't go and join the army because they needed you in the Foreign Service. So my father was stuck, and it was for him very, very awkward and embarrassing, all his friends going to war, and nearly all of them being killed, while he was tucked up warm in London. He didn't really like that a bit, you know. In 1916, I remember my mother telling me that by the end of 1916, every man she had ever danced with was dead. I mean, the holocaust of young officers was absolutely unbelievable. And then in 1916, Lloyd George took over from Asquith. And by this time, there were hardly any young officers left. So he allowed other categories of people to go and be drafted, including people in the Foreign Office. So my father then went and joined the army. But this was only at the end of 1916 that the law went through. And he then had, you know, I suppose delays, and then he had his training and all that. So he really didn't get to the front until early in 1918. So he had less than a year there. I mean, if he'd had 4 years, he'd have been killed and I wouldn't be here talking to you now. I have no doubt at all. But as it was, he only had a short time, during which he distinguished himself to the point of being recommended for the VC. He didn't get it, but he got a very good DSO, which for a young officer is the sort of the next best thing, because he had advanced with a platoon, I suppose, behind him on this German army post, which was machine gunning everybody. And he advanced, and he got there, and without having been shot. But when he got there, turned around and saw that he was the only one of the platoon we had. All the other men had been killed, and all he could think of to do was to shout. He spoke a certain amount of German, to shout surrender. And to his astonishment, 18 German soldiers came out with their hands above their heads, and it was only him. That is his story. I mean, he may have been over-modest about it, but that's his version of the story. Anyway, this young lieutenant came back with a dozen Germans, and having certainly risked death on his way to the thing. So there it was. And he then, soon afterwards, left the Foreign Office and wanted to go into politics. He had no money. It cost a certain amount to go into politics in those days, but fortunately my mother started making a lot of money in stage and screen. I think I've told you about that already. And so that financed his early steps in politics.